Many tribal groups such as Van Gujjars of the Punjab Hills and the Lambadis of Andhra Pradesh were pastoralists. So these are the two types of tribal group. They were the pastoralists. That means they used to do the agriculture. One Gujjar woman, you can see in this picture. They lived by herding and rearing animals. So they lived how? By caring the animals and by rearing the animals. These people lived on the outskirt of forest. So they used to live in the outskirt. That means nearby the forest, and maintain their existence exclusively by sale of milk, ghee and other produce for their herds. So they used to maintain their existence by selling the milk, ghee and other produce which they get from their animals. Some tribal groups settled down at one place. So there are many tribal groups who used to settle down at one place. Gradually they got the ownership rights to the land they have cultivated for some years. So as they lived in one place, so that's why they have got the ownership rights, as they have cultivated for some years in that particular area. In many cases the land belonged to the clan as a whole. So in many places the land belonged to the clan, that means the whole community. All members of the clan were regarded as descendant of an original ancestor. So clan means that means belong to one family. So all the members of the family were regarded as the, you can see, descendant, that means heirs of the original ancestors. Towards the beginning of the 19th century, the various tribal groups who lived in hilly forested tracts started practicing agriculture. So towards the beginning of the 19th century, many tribal groups, they lived in a hilly forest area and started practicing agriculture. They practice what is called shifting agriculture or jhum. That is, once the crop was ready and harvested, they move on to the another patch of land. So the jhum cultivation or shifting cultivation, it was started by the tribal people, and they practice in the hilly region. And the meaning of the shifting agriculture is that they have cultivated, for example, in this piece of land they have cultivated rice. Okay, so once they cultivate the rice, and after cultivating the rice they harvested it, they will leave this place and they will move to another piece of land. Same when the, for example, wheat is cultivated, they will, after harvesting, they will move to another land. So this is called shifting agriculture or jhum cultivation. A field that has been cultivated once was left fallow for several years and the natural vegetation was allowed to regrow. So once they cultivate in a small piece of land, they leave it for several years so that they can, so the fertility of that particular land can be again regained. And once they leave that particular land, the natural vegetation, they used to grow different types of natural vegetation in that particular area. As supplies from the forest produce dwindled, some tribal people started carrying loads or working as laborer in the field of settled agriculturists. So as the supplies of the forest produce increases in the different types of cities and town, so some tribal people, they started carrying different types of wood and started working as a laborer so that they can earn a small amount of money, especially in the settled agriculturist. Impact of colonial rule on tribal life. Now we will learn what were the different types of impact which happened on the tribal people when the British rule came in India. Prior to the colonial rule, the tribal societies had lived in relative isolation for hundreds of years. So regarding to the colonial rule, the tribal societies, they lived in a relative isolation. That means they does not bother what is happening in the world or what is happening in the society. They just live in isolation for hundreds of years. Colonial rule threw a deep impact on the tribal society of India. So once the British rule arrived in our India, it also affected the tribal society. As the colonial rule expanded, the social and cultural life of these people underwent several changes. So as the British rule expanded in the Indian territories, the social and cultural life of the tribal people also changes. Many previously unadministered tribal areas were brought under the control of the British. So there were many unadministered tribal areas. They were now brought under the control of the British. Now British will rule these areas. outsiders who had not been keen to go into these areas previously could do so under the protection of the colonial state. So earlier any people were not allowed to enter in the tribal areas before the British rule, but now they can go they can easily go as because that particular area was under the British rule. So that's why now anybody can go, and this whole area was under the British or colonial state. With commercialization of land, expansion of cultivation, and dependent and demand for cash revenue, outsiders settled down in tribal areas. As a result, large tract of tribal land were transferred into non-tribal outsiders. So as the main objective of the British was to exploit the Indian resources, right? So once the commercialization, that means buying and selling of the land, expanded, there was also expansion in the cultivation also, and plus the demand for cash revenue, that means tax also increases, due to which many outsiders they started settling downing in the tribal areas. As a result, large amount of tribal land were now transferred to the non-tribal people who were not belong to their clan or their culture. The tribal people were practically deprived of all the rights. So the tribal people were not given any rights. All the rights were taken from them because of British rule. While in principle, the colonial state followed a policy of non-intervention in tribal matters, the colonial laws and rules worked against such malevolent desire. So due to the British rule, the Britishers, they started to follow a policy of not intervention in tribal matters. That means they were not at all interested in the tribal matters. Their main agenda was to capture the areas, okay? And the colonial laws were not given importance to them. And if they wanted to do anything, they have to take permission from the British rule. And if they do anything without the permission of the Britishers, they were punished. So these were the different types of impacts because of the colonial rule on the tribal life. Let us now look at some of the key factors that lead to substantial change in the tribal societies during the colonial rule. So now we will discuss one by one what are the different types of factors which finally changes the tribal societies during the British rule in detail. Administration of tribal areas. The British allowed the tribal chiefs to continue enjoying their land titles over a group of villages, but they were told to administer these under British control and supervision and according to British law in India. So though the tribal people, they were given the land to live there, to have their basic needs, okay, to do their day-to-day activities, but what did the Britishers? They said that you can do anything, but these whole areas will be now under the control of the British rule, and you have to follow certain rules and regulations which the Britishers will decide. British land revenue rules, British police regulation, British forest law, etc., came to govern tribal areas as well. So different types of laws were you can say applied in the tribal areas. Thus, the tribal chiefs lost much of the authority which they had earlier enjoyed. So, as the Britishers, when they started capturing the tribal areas, the tribal chief, that means the tribal head, he lost his authority. Why? Because now British started controlling that areas.